a year it is to be Kenny Rogers. Isn't this amazing?
Wow. I mean, it's tiring. I don't know any other word for it.
Be careful what you wish for.
Yeah, because I'll probably do 100 dates this year, and I'll do, you know, 30 at Christmas time, 27 one right after the other. But yeah, I enjoy it. But
you can't make old friends. You can't make old friends. I mean, obviously the inspiration is seeing a younger generation enjoy what you do for a living. That had to make the whole recording process a pleasure.
It did. You know, and on this album, I tried to step out of my comfort zone. Yeah. Normally I do ballads that say what every man would like to say and every woman would like to hear, or I do songs that have social significance. But I stepped out of my comfort zone. I did a song called Turn This World Around.
It's my favorite.
It's almost like a nursery rhyme, but a hard rock nursery rhyme, you know? And I think it's so unlike anything I've done in so long. We'll see if it pays off.
But you can't make old friends.
So you look at this collection, you can't help but mention the reunion of two of the greatest entertainers we have, and that's Kenny and Dolly.
I was working at a place called Stagecoach, and this kid comes backstage and he said, I'm Ryan King. He was William King of the Commodore's son. And he said, I just have to tell you, I was meeting with some friends of mine the other day, and I was telling them that the happiest memories that I have are going to your place when I was 10 and 12 and riding golf carts. And I realized, you can't make old friends. The next day I'm in New York helping Don Schlitz, and I told him the story, and he says, oh, can I take a shot at writing that? The next day I had a song from him, and he said, it's perfect for you and Dolly. Boy, does she sing great on that.
Well, you both sound fantastic on it, like you've been singing this song for 30 years.
And she learned it and came in and did it the same night, you know. I would love to, just for the fun of it, do 8 or 10 shows for the year, just because I love working with her. In her heart, she would love to do it too, but how we do it is another story.
These are the little things I need the most in my life.
The other big thing happening in a couple of weeks, one of the greatest honors an entertainer could possibly receive, and that's induction into the Country Music Hall of Fame. What was your reaction?
Steve Moore called me and he said, I'm the president of the Hall of Fame. I wanted to call you personally and tell you that you're being inducted into the Hall of Fame this year. Thank you just seemed so unimportant at that time. There must have been something more important, better that I could say. But I just said, I want you to know how much I appreciate you and everyone else who's helped make this come about. And I'm glad it's happening now. But rather than at the peak of my career, because I had so many things happening then, I don't think I would have appreciated as much. And it's something that lasts forever. It's not a temporary thing. So that's exciting.